7:30 in the light. I get those goosebumps every time you come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah.
I know a lot of girls and guys, they want to know more about Bridal.
I get those goosebumps every time I need the hype. Throw that to the side, yo. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yo.
So I just wanted to
get those goosebumps every time, yeah. 713 through the 281, yeah, I'm riding. Why they on me? Why they on me? I'm flying, zipping low key. I'm zipping low key in Onyx.
I'm riding.
But I'm pulling up right beside you. Pop star Lil Mariah. When I take skin game wireless, throw a stack on the bob. On the Snapchat, I took Molly. She fall through plenty, her and all her guineas. Yeah. We at the top, so floor, right there off Dewy. Yeah.
And I know
oh no, I can't fuck with y'all. Yeah, when I'm with my squad, I cannot do no wrong. Yeah, so smoking in the city,
but
don't get missing
from. Yeah, they gon' pull up on you.
Yeah,
so
we gon' do some things, some things you can't relate. Yeah, cause we from a place you cannot stay. Or you can't go, or I don't know. Or back the fuck up off me.
I actually used a different highlight today, which I'm so happy I did. I used a product I haven't used in a long time.
I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.
You can skip.
I get those goosebumps every time.
Ignore it.
I need the high. Throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah.
That's just how it
I
is.
Get those goosebumps every time.
I wanna press my light, yeah. I wanna press my.
It's my
I wanna green like I wanna be like I wanna press my line, yeah. I wanna take that ride, yeah. I'm gonna press my line. I wanna green like I wanna be like I wanna press my. Oh my dear, spare your feelings. I'm reliving moments, feeling more resilient. Buy the building, burn the building, take your bitch, rebuild the building just to fuck somebody, just to find my love for you. Touch the sky, forgot to stop the beat.
I apply my contour, bronzer, and base.
Need a pipe or pick your pepper so I can pick your brain and put your heart together. Need to part the shady parts and party heart, the diamond shows the cool forever. My best shot just might shoot forever like.
I get those goosebumps every time you come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too dumb, yeah. It's way too dumb.
Like I
get those goosebumps every time. I need the high. Throw that to the side. I get those goosebumps every time. Yeah, when you're not around, when you throw that to the side. I get those goosebumps every time.
Love it. Like, look at my skin. My skin is flawless. Like, I don't think my skin's ever looked this good. Like, I think I'm gonna do that routine. I might do that routine tomorrow. But something I did different in this today's video, before I applied the eyeshadow. So after I did foundation, concealer, powder, eyebrows, I applied the Morphe Continuous Setting Spray to basically melt all the powder, melt the powder into your skin. So my skin looked really flawless and dewy, basically looked like skin, didn't look like I had a ton of makeup on. So I find like that really sealed the deal. Yeah, I find like, I don't know. My skin is like super hydrated. It's not super cakey. I'm just loving how I did my makeup today. I should do this every day. Like the way I did it today is flawless. And yeah, and it lasts all day, I have to say, when I did my makeup today. So I'm really happy with that. Yeah, I might do that every day. Just saying. Yeah, I think. Yeah, and just doing that continuous setting mist right before applying eyeshadow, it just like melted everything into the skin. I might do that every day, yeah. And I hope you guys take all the tricks that I added in today's in today's video. And I'm gonna do this, like, do you guys ever do like makeup and then you do something new and then you bring it into your daily routine? I think what I did for today's video, I'm gonna take it to my daily routine. I'm gonna take it there. I'm just going with that. Just saying. So I did apply this 3 times and I think it just made my skin like really dewy and kind of melted into the skin, and I love it. Anyways, you guys, I loved everything about today's video. I know I took a day off yesterday because my boyfriend came over and I didn't really have time. It's 10:30 right now, so I feel a little bit tired, but I tried to like include and do step by step for you guys so you guys can have a flawless, modern bridal makeup tutorial. And I loved how this looked. I wear this on a regular basis and I don't care. I'm ready to get married now. Anyways, you guys, I hope you really enjoy this tutorial, this makeup tutorial. So much fun. I have to add this because it's very bridal. But everything I did in today's tutorial wasn't too hard, I don't think. It was really, really easy to do. And hopefully you guys could do an everyday look or use these tips and tricks as, like, if you guys are getting married, it's okay. And I'm sure when this pandemic is over, you'll be on your way to the altar and getting married to your man. And it's okay. You guys aren't engaged. It's okay. I'm not engaged either. I just wanted to do a tutorial for today's look. So I'm a bride today. Anyways, you guys, I had so much fun. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And for tomorrow's look, I think I'm going to do a bold eye. I was thinking of doing like a pink smoky tutorial because I haven't done a really, really pink eye. And I'm going to do a matte pink eye tomorrow. I just want to do something really different on my YouTube channel. I've been doing really bold lip colors and I just want to do something different and do like really bold eyes because I think a lot of people right now, they're bored and they want to have some fun. And I think a pink, I love doing a pink smoky eye. It brings out my eyes really nicely and it's fun. And I might do a red liner with a nude lip. I'm into it, and do like a pink highlight. Whenever I do a pink smoky eye, I like to do a more pink highlight because it just brings out the pinkness more. Yeah, I'm gonna look to my palettes and see what kind of look I can come up with. Anyways, you guys, don't forget to subscribe. I love you guys so much and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm super excited for this bridal makeup, but I just wanted to do like the base first and the foundation. Yeah, because everyone has different like skin types and you guys aren't going to use the same foundation concealer powder as me. Obviously you guys don't have my skin type because I'm super, super dry, and everything that I use I always put in the description box anyway, so I just decided to do the base. Now we're going to do the modern day a bridal makeup for today's look. So basically you want to scrub, cleanse your face, basically just do a really nice exfoliation the day of or the night before. But if you're super sensitive or you have rosacea, do it the night before so you don't want to be all blotchy on the day of your wedding. I'm not that sensitive. I am, but it doesn't affect me. So usually I do it like the night before or the day of kind of thing. Just do that. And especially your lips, you want to use lip balm, scrub, and then a really good like moisturizer for your lips. And I'm have my lip balm on because my lips are super dry. We're going to do like a matte kind of lip color, very neutral. And yeah, so I already did my foundation, concealer, powder. So for any type of wedding makeup, I want the skin to look so flawless and I want the skin to look really dewy and just look like skin. I don't want it to look like makeup. So I'm going to go in. So I did, oh yeah, I did foundation, concealer, powder, under eye powder, and I did my eyebrows. So basically, I just want to spray some Morphe Continuous Setting Spray just to make it like really hydrated and dewy and basically look really flawless for the day of my wedding. Let's pretend I'm getting married, which I'm not. Okay, we're just going to spray. So basically, this is just gonna like make the powder settle in your face. So And then I used my Amazon fan. I got this off Amazon. They have other colors, but I like pink. And just be careful. We're not going to contour before we do eyeshadow. We're going to do our makeup a little different today. We're actually not going to bake that much. We're just going to preheat the oven, basically. So preheating, like, just put it on quickly and take it off. Because I don't want to have, like, a really long-lasting bakage. Because it dries out your skin. And I don't want to be dry on my wedding day. So this is what I do for brides all the time. Also, they don't really like it because they think it's, like, super cakey, but you can do it, like, just before and take it off right away, and it works the same. I usually do it on a regular basis because I want my makeup to last for a really long time, and that's just how I always do my makeup. But for a wedding day, I don't want it to be too dry and too cakey because you are going to be wearing this all day long. So, yeah. Okay, now we're going to start with the eye makeup. It's so weird not to, like, contour and bake, but we're gonna do it different. So my skin is looking really good and hydrated, and I want that. I want that kind of dewy, basically, to melt the powder into the skin. Okay, I'm just gonna start with the Jaclyn Hill palette. I'm just gonna do, like, a really neutral eye look. I'm not gonna go too crazy today, just because I find, like, with a lot of bridal makeup, they don't do a crazy look. I, like, organized all my makeup the other day, and, like, I organized it, so I don't know where to put anything right now, so. Okay, now, which brush do I want to go in with? I think I'm going to use this one. This is the Morphe Rose Gold Collection in the R37, and I'm just going to go in with Silk Cream. I know, it's a lot of pan, but this is what I'm using. I haven't bought more. I'm going to eventually when the stores open up again. I heard the store's gonna open up at the end of May, but who knows. Okay, we're just gonna take some silk cream, and we're just gonna place it basically in the socket of the eye. Feels so weird not applying contour, bronzer, and then adding my bakeage. It's like, who am I? But this is just what I do for wedding days. I find, like, when I do bake for a lot of bridesmaids or, like, brides, I find, like, they get dry skin here. That's why I do the setting spray method. And then I do this part. So I'm not really worried about how high I'm putting the eyebrow. Yeah. Okay, now we're gonna just gonna use some bakeage. What is this? This is the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Instant Retouch a Setting Powder in the shade of Lavender. I want, like, a really brightening effect, so this setting powder is perfect. So we're just going to place this under the eye. And we did that setting powder method because I knew we were going to go in with so much powder. I want the skin to look really, like, dewy and refreshed. I know, my makeup area is so clean. I don't even, like, want to mess it up, you know? Do you guys ever get like that? My back is killing me, too. Okay, moving on. We're just going to use that same R37 brush. We're going to go in with Silk Cream again. We're just going to accentuate that cat eye, basically. Swirl in my brush. Okay, so we're just going to apply that. Continue and basically make a cat eye. Perfect. Okay, now that we applied that Silk Cream color, we're just going to go in with Pukey. And I'm just using, ooh, sorry guys. I'm just using the same brush I was using, the R37. And I love using the shade Pukey. And we're just going to put this like below that silk cream we applied all over the lid. Just right below this. Especially for a wedding day, I want to like build the color. You know, I want it to be like very flowy and ha! Basically just... Okay, we're going to use a different brush. I'm just going to go in with the Morphe 433. I love this brush for like blending the outer corner. We're going to go in with a Buns. This is a really pretty color because it has a really pretty rosy undertone. And I want the darker browns that we're using are really warm. And I want this kind of rosiness. It's going to complement the darker colors we're going to use later. But just taking that tap off the excess. And then just tap really lightly in the outer corner of the eye. Just tap, tap, tap. And then blend it out. Not too much. I feel like that's too much, but don't worry, it's gonna blend out. Before I like move on to like the next color, I always make sure everything is blended. Because if it's not blended and you add another color, it's gonna be even harder to blend. Just saying. Okay, now we're gonna go in with a darker color. I'm gonna go in with Central Park. Yeah, I think it's Central Park. It's like this really pretty espresso shade. And it has a really neutral brown to it. And I think I want to play with that. So we're just using the same brush we were using before. But this is a really pigmented brown. So just tap a little bit at a time. Because we don't want to be too overpowering. Okay. We're just going to tap that on the outer corner. Just building that outer corner. And just like blend like that. Yeah, it's looking, I know I look a little scary, but it's going to come together, you guys. And then just tap, 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 tap. Okay, now we're going to go in with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. This is the Ring the Alarm palette. I love this palette, and I'm going to go in with this really warm, chocolatey brown in the shade Secret. If you guys watch my channel, I love this color. It's just so rich and warm, and I don't know, it's like a real pretty chocolate color, and I love it. Okay, we're just gonna use the same M433 and just dip really lightly because this brown is pigmented, and tap. And then we're just gonna go really lightly on the outer corner. I'm gonna do a little bit of a cut crease today, but I just want to add some warmth to the outer corner. I want this to be really sultry. You know? Kind of blend upwards. Yeah, that's so pretty, you guys. I do the other eye. That's a looking real good. Okay, now we're gonna go in with Obsessed and SBN for this two shades. I love mixing them together because it's kind of like that taupey gold champagne kind of color, which like if you are a makeup artist, you guys will love this color because that's basically like what every bride wants in their makeup. They're like, I want smoky but natural, but not too smoky. They all say that. So you want like a kind of taupey gold kind of color. They all go for the same freaking look. And like makeup artists like don't like make fun of each other because it's so funny. It's like I want smoky, but I want too smoky. And like same with nude lips. They want a nude lip, but they don't want too nude. But they want like a little pink in there, but they don't want too pink. There's just like I find my brides, they're so indecisive. Like they'll tell you I want a really natural look. But then like they want a wing liner. It's like wing liner is not like it's not natural. Like for makeup artists, it's like that's not natural, that's like a bang on smoky eye. It's just like women I find don't know what they want, and it's hard for them to describe. We're just going to spray the brush, and I'm using the MAC 242, and I don't know what they want. Like hairdressers, like say a client wants to be blonde and then she shows you a picture, she's like the picture is basically Pam Anderson's like white blonde, and she wants to be like a beach blonde. It's like the customer or the client's eyes are so different than what like a makeup artist or hairdresser sees. Like I just think it's so funny. Okay, we're just gonna apply this all over the lid basically. And I spray my brush because I want it to be really metallic, especially on my wedding day. Like, ooh, girl. Okay, we're just gonna tap that all over. And I want to do basically like a cut crease almost, because I want my eyes to be really open, especially because I have small eyes, and especially on my wedding day. Like for me, like when I used to go clubbing with my girlfriends, I could never open my eyes. And I don't know, I have like, my eyes are really sensitive, but I want my eyes to be really open for my wedding day. No, I'm not getting married. Okay, now that we put that kind of taupey brown champagne color all over, I'm going to do something real fun. So we're just going to go in with SBN, and we're going to use our finger. Quick side note, I know my nails are like really ugly, but I'm taking a break from shellac because my nails are really thin. So I just put Nail Envy on my nails. I might put polish for a few weeks just because they're like, they're so thin and they hurt. So I just have to tell you. So we're just going to use our finger. I usually use my ring finger. And we're just going to tap that at the end. Like that. I just love using my finger at the end there. We're going to do the other finger. Just right at the end. I want to like blend in with the outer corner matte shades. And I want a more gold. And I always like the inner corner when I apply a shimmer to be like lighter than the outer corner. I just think it's like really beautiful. It just makes my eyes stand out. Okay, now we're going to do something real fun. We're going to grab in light with just using my finger. Again, and we're just going to put this in the center. So, grab my finger. I love doing this. And I just want to pop some in the center. Just really lightly. Like that. Because I got some of the shimmer into the crease, I'm just going to use the M506 with no product on it. And I'm just like going to buff that out basically. Just because you want your eyes to be perfect, especially on my wedding day. Okay, we're going to grab that in light with the left hand. Just like really lightly. It's such a pretty color. Just go in the center wedding day, and I don't want dry under eyes, let me tell you. Okay, like that, yeah. Okay, Moving on. I'm just going to use, this is the Morphe E18 brush. I love this brush for applying my first shadow on the lower lash line. Okay, we're going to go in with a Beauty. Just because. You know? Just because I feel like it. Okay, we're just going to apply this all underneath. Yeah, it's looking good. Okay, and then we're just going to grab this definer brush. This is the Morphe M423. And we're just going to grab Central Park, that XOXO shade we've been using. Just going to grab a little at a time, honestly. Because this stuff, like, I find with darker, especially brown shadows, they're really pigmented. So, let's apply that. I know it looks scary, but it's gonna come together. Okay, and then we're going to grab, this is the Morphe from the Rose Gold collection. This is the R41. We're just going to grab buns again. I want that rosy kind of shadow all over. All over the under eye. And just blend that out. Kind of like want to smoke it out. Okay, and then I'm just going to go in with that Kylie brush, and we're just going to go in with, I'm just going to show you, with buns again. I'm just going to dip really lightly. And blend it out. I want to really smoke. So we're doing more of a sultry, smoky kind of wedding look. I want the lower lash line to be really smoky under. Okay, we're gonna apply some more translucent powder. Just to make it perfect, you know? Yeah, I'm looking real cute. I'm so thirsty. Hang on. What am I drinking? I'm drinking the XO Pellegrino. This is the blood orange one. I had it at the dollar store. It's so good. Okay, I'm gonna conceal my eyebrows. Quickly stay. I'm just going back in with the Tarte shape tape, the concealer I was using earlier. Where's my concealer brush? I'm just going to use this M32 just to kind of clean it up. Especially for my wedding day, this is what makes my makeup such a difference. Sure. Okay, I'm going to use this guy. This is the Morphe M213. I'm just going to go in with Enlight and Beam. Just because I want to mix, you know? I'm just going to pat really lightly on the eyebrow. Just to give a highlighted brow. I want it popping, you know. Like that, yeah. Yes. Okay, and then now we're gonna add some extra pop. I'm just gonna go in with the Jaclyn Hill Morphe palette. This is the Armed and Gorgeous palette. I'm just gonna go in with VIP with that same bullet brush we were using. I'm just gonna tap really lightly in the inner corner. Just because I want an extra pop, especially on my wedding day, because it's gonna pow at ya. Just really lightly. Oh my god. It's a little too much, but whatever. I'm gonna be honest. My wedding day, I'm gonna rock anything. I tell you that. So I'm just using the MAC Cosmetics Kohl eyeliner in the shade Fascinating. It's my favorite white eyeliner of all time because it's so pigmented and it's so popping. Literally just have to swipe once and it's there. Okay. Just gonna pop that right there. Like that, yeah. Like, it just opens your eyes so much, you guys. Popping. Okay, just like. Okay, now, what do I want to do? I think I'm going to apply under eye powder at this time. I'm going to use the Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Airbrush Flawless Finish Skin Perfecting Micro Powder in the shade One Fair. So we're just going to use the tip of the sponge. I'm just going to dip in here. I love this powder because it's so soft and it's just such a beautiful powder, especially it's like $60. So on my wedding day, I'm going to use it. So we're just going to apply right under the eye. Just like that. We're going to do the center of the face, but we're going to contour the nose, but I just want to leave that powder on. Because I find, like, with my nose, I am on the dry side, but my nose is more combo, kind of. And I notice, like, when you're hugging people, kissing, drinking drinks, like, basically, like, your nose is always the first to, like, disappear. And I want that powder to be on, like, longer, just because I want it to basically, you know, I find, like, with the nose, that's, like, the first to go. And we don't want, you know, our makeup fading all throughout the day. We want to leave that on there, just saying. Okay. Moving on. I'm actually going to do something different today just because I just need a brush. I'm just going to use this one. This is the Morphe 432. And I'm just going to go in with Abyss. I'm just going to place the shadow on the line. I like doing this as the last part because if I place my under eye powder and kind of looked up, it'll ruin my whole eyeshadow, and I don't want to do that. So I'm just going to dip really lightly in that Abyss color. I'm using this color because it's really, it's really, really black, and I want a really black shadow. So I'm just going to tap the excess off and just tap on the lash line. and this is gonna make our eyes really, really smoky. Just like that, lightly tap. And this will make it so easy to apply the lashes, but it just adds like a really smoky effect. And I want that. Yeah. Like that. Yes, bitch. We're gonna apply some mascara. I'm just gonna apply this one because this is the one I always use. I would use this on my wedding day. This is actually a waterproof one, so it'd be perfect for my wedding day. Usually don't wear waterproof, but if you're getting married and you know you're gonna cry, like, I'm an emotional being. Like, I'm so emotional all the time. I cry all the time. Like, I cried yesterday and I cried today, probably because it's my special time. But if you're not a crier, you don't have to wear waterproof mascara. But I know I wouldn't cry on my wedding day, so I'm gonna. But usually I don't. Okay, we're just gonna use the L'Oreal Paris Voluminous Lash of Paradise. This is my favorite. I'm just gonna apply a thin coat. I find with longer lashes, they really open your eyes. I find with shorter lashes, they kind of make your eyes smaller. Like if you do short and thick lashes and you're into that, I don't like that type of look. I like long, thick, flirty, like really voluminous lashes. That's my thing because I have small eyes and I want to open my eyes. And I find the longer the lash you wear, they definitely open your eyes more. And these are the double lift lashes, so these actually have two layers, which I love. Okay, I'm just gonna see if it like looks pretty. I always do this. Ooh, yeah. Okay, I'm happy. Perfect. Okay, I need some lash glue. Okay, now 60 seconds are up. I'm just gonna use some tweezers. Just gonna apply this right on the lash line. Ooh. It's so weird, like, doing my makeup different today. I feel, like, awkward. But whatever. Perfect. Like, because we put that black shadow on the lash line, it was so easy to put that lash on. If you guys don't know how to apply lashes, just do that trick. Like, put liner. It's so easy to see, like, where you apply on your lash line. One of my coworkers told me, like, how do you apply lashes so close to your lash line? I was like, it's so easy. But if you guys can't do it, just try that shadow trick. It works every time. Literally took me 2 seconds to apply that lash. Okay, we're gonna do the other eye. And it, like, I don't know, applying that black shadow on the lash line, it just, I don't know, there's something about it. It just kind of, like, lifts that kind of eye look. And it looks smoky at the same time, but not too smoky. I love it. And it kind of, like, makes your, like, lashes look longer. I don't know. I feel like it's not on, but whatever. Something different. I want to be different, y'all. Okay. I'm going to go in. It's wet because I washed it yesterday. I'm going to use the Dior Backstage Contour Palette. I love this contour powder. It's so beautiful. And if you look at the reviews on Sephora, a lot of other people like it as well. And I'm going to use these two contour shades. Okay, what brush do I want to use? I think I'm just going to use, oh my god, my brushes are so dirty all the time. I don't know why. We're just going to go in with the Morphe times Jaclyn Hill brush. This is the JHO5. Okay, I haven't used this brush in a while. It's clean. And we're just going to dip in those two contour shades really lightly. And tap. See, it's such a beautiful color. I love it. I don't know, I love it. It's such a beautiful color. Okay, and then the forehead. Yeah, I don't know. I just love this contour powder so much. I love pairing it with the Charlotte Tilbury powder when I highlight, like, these two products together. I don't know. They're so beautiful. Yeah, it just has such a beautiful finish, you know? Okay. Now, I'm going to use bronzer. What bronzer do I want to use? I think I'm going to use this one. This is a Morphe bronzer. I know this isn't bougie, but I love this bronzer. And this bronzer is actually really good. I've never had a problem with it. It doesn't, like, go blotchy throughout the day. It's not overly cakey. It's actually, like, this should be, like, a $50 bronzer, but it's a really beautiful bronzer. And it has a really pretty kind of golden undertone, which is what I want for this kind of look. So I don't want something too pale. So this is the Morphe Glamour Bronze Face and Body Bronzer in the shade Icon. This is like their old packaging. So I think their new packaging is like black. But this is the shade Icon. It's such a beautiful color. Okay, I'm just going to use this Morphe times Jaclyn Hill brush. This is the JHO2. I love this brush, especially for my wedding day. I want like a really kind of bronzy look for today's wedding look. Okay, we're just going to apply this. Yeah, it's so pretty. Because we did kind of a sultry, smoky eye, we want a really, like, complimentary bronzer, especially with warmer undertones. It's going to be really complimentary with this look. And I'm going to add near the temple. It's so weird applying bronzer after my shadow. I don't know. We're going to bake. And for translucent powder, I'm just going to use the Laura Mercier translucent powder. Just because this is like basically a really nice lightweight translucent powder. And this is going to basically stand the test of time. Because this will be really good. Because this stuff lasts all day long. Which is perfect for our wedding day. Oh, my back is really killing me for some reason. I was bending down cleaning yesterday, and my back was like, my boyfriend's like, you don't want me to come over? I was like, no, I'm just telling you, my back is killing me. I was so tired after I organized all my makeup yesterday. I was like, what's wrong with me? Okay. We're just going to preheat the oven with the bake. basically. I'm going to take it off. But I'm going to contour my nose before I take it off, because I don't want to just put it on and then take it off right away. It won't do anything. I'm just going to use this slanted goat hair Kylie brush. And I'm going to use the Icon bronzer. I like to use bronzer to contour my nose because my nose is already... of a really high bridge. I don't really need a definition. Basically, I just want to add a little bit color with the Apply Actual Contour Powder. I find it's too harsh. So if you guys don't really have like a nose per se, or if you like, what the hell are they doing? My neighbors are doing something next door and I can hear them. Anyways, if you guys don't really have a high bridge like me, like I would say using actual contour powder, that would help like show that you have a nose per se. But if you guys don't really need definition for your nose, I suggest using bronzer. I'm just going to go in with that Morphe Icon shade. I don't know, they're like flicking lights or something next door is so annoying. It's a little like harsh, but whatever. I really don't care at this rate. I'm just gonna take that off. Like that, and then we're just gonna use some of that Charlotte Tilbury powder with the sponge. I need the mirror though. I'm wearing this. Ooh, that's a lot, but whatever. We're just gonna work with it, and a little bit on the forehead. And like applying powder on the nose. I find it like makes a difference. Like the contrast kind of shows up your nose more. Like look at my nose right now. Like that nose is snatched. Like the contrast of the highlighting powder and the nose contour, it just makes your nose pop more. Not that my nose needs it. Just saying. Okay. Now we're just gonna take that baggage off. Where's my brush? Oh my god, I can't find my pink brush. Here it is. Just using this Jeffree Star brush. This is the JS1. I'm just gonna take all that baggage off. They stop now, my neighbors, like making noise, like finally. It might be 7 o'clock. What time is it? It's like 7. So I think it's that time where like cheering for the hospital people. I was talking to my boyfriend yesterday about it. He's like, it's stupid and it's loud. I was like, I know. Okay, we're just gonna go back in with that Charlotte Tilbury powder. And we're just gonna pat that in the bottom of the face. Because I just love how this looks. Looks really highlighted, especially for my wedding day. I want to be highlighted. Long time. time, my makeup looks better for some reason. And it's not as dry here. I might do that method. Like, yeah. I probably wouldn't spray setting spray before I do my actual eye makeup. But, like, the contour and the highlight, like, the contour and the bronzer and then baking after, like doing my eyeshadow and then my contour and bronzer and baking after. I kind of like that idea. I don't know. I'm living for my makeup. I haven't done this method in a long time. Okay. We're going to go on with blush. Blush do I want to use? I'm going to go in with MAC. I'm going to use Melba. And then I'm going to go in with Copper Tone. I love these two blushes together. They're so beautiful. I'm just going to use this brush. This is the Morphe Y4. This is from their Rose Gold collection. Such a beautiful line of brushes. Yeah, these two blushes mixed together, like, they're basically my perfect blush for any bride, especially Melba, because Melba is such a kind of peachy kind of blush. It's perfect for really fair brides. Okay, we're just going to apply this really lightly. Like this. And I kind of like that I didn't have to reapply bronzer doing, like, my contour, bronzer, and bakeage after my eyes. Because usually when I do that, because I apply under eye powder after, like, basically I lose all my bronzer in the middle of my cheeks. And I find I didn't have to do that today, which I kind of like. Maybe I'll do my makeup like that from now on. Do you guys ever get, like, your little moods, like you'll do something new that you actually like it better than when you did your makeup before? I always do that. Like, I never used to bake. I used to always apply my eyes first, and then I, like, applied the rest of my face. But then I started doing, like, my base first, because I find, like, when you do your foundation first and the rest of your face, instead of doing your eyes first, it's quicker and it doesn't take as long. Yes. Okay, for a bride, you cannot live without this powder. I am telling you, this is a staple if you're a bride, okay? This is the Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder. You cannot go without this. This is very essential for every bride because it gives you such a dewy kind of glow from within. And when you're a bride, you want to be really glowy and happy. And, you know, that's what brides do. That's why I did a very kind of, like, I didn't do a really strong blush. I wanted a really soft, cheeky kind of, like, cheek. Same with this product. This product will give you a really pretty glow and you want to be glowing. So we're going to apply this. And this is in the shade Luminous Light. You guys know I love this product. I use this basically in every one of my videos. I have other ones that I like, but I don't like them as much as this. Like the Jaclyn Cosmetics, they have one I like and called Do Me. And then Laura Mercier has a translucent powder, but it's a glow one. I don't like it as much. It's a little too shimmery. This one, I don't know. They put something in it, and I love it. It's like voodoo, and it's like the perfect color. It's like a very champagne color. Like, they do have other colors, but I love this color. It's just so beautiful. It's the perfect color for my skin tone when I'm tan and pale. But if you guys are darker or lighter, there's other colors too. Just check. Okay, I'm going in with the Morphe M500. I'm just going to tap a little at a time and just basically brush that all over the cheeks. Yeah. Oh my god, I love this product. Oh my god. Yeah, it's just so beautiful. Like, if you're a bride, you definitely need this product. It just gives you a very, like, nice inner glow. Just gonna, okay, now we're gonna go back in with the Morphe Continue Setting Spray. Basically, I want my highlight to be really, really beaming right now, and I always do this right before, and especially for my wedding day, I want a beaming highlight, so that's why we added that Luminous Light Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder, because we want, basically, we want a little bit of a glow, and then when we put the actual highlight, the highlight's going to be beaming, and this is part of it. So we just want that kind of dewy glow. And this will, like, melt, like, any over, like, if you powder your face too much, this will basically melt everything. Like, say you put too much under eye powder, this will melt everything into the skin. I've used this on my channel before. This is Dior. This is their Dior Backstage Glow Face Palette, and it's so pretty. It has, they have the original one, I'll show you. It's this one, but I only use these first two colors, but this is the peachy one. Yeah, what is this? This is 002 Glitz, and then this is a 001 Universal. Like, I love this one, and they came out with this one, and I was like, bitch, I gotta go get it. Okay, we're gonna use this. I think I'm gonna use the first two ones. Sorry, it's hard to hold because the thing doesn't pop up, but these two shades. So this is, this color is called Glitter Strobe Gold, and this is called Glitter Strobe Pink Gold, and I just want to mix them together because I kind of want, like, kind of a pale gold highlight. We're gonna go in with a loose highlighter that's more gold, but this is my vibe right now. We're just gonna go in with the Morphe x Jeffree Star. This is the JS4. Okay, just gonna dip. I haven't used this in a long time, so this is what we're doing. Apply to the cheeks. Oh my god, that's so beautiful, you guys. Yeah. And I don't want to say, like, I want a beaming highlight, but I know how this is going to go. It's going to be beaming. Let's be real. I was in the aisle, like, standing with my future husband. I want my highlight to be popping. Just saying. Just like that. Oh yeah, that's intense, bitch. I definitely look bridal now. Yeah, these two colors mixed together are so beautiful, guys. So beautiful. Okay, and then now we're going to go in with those two shades, but I'm going to use my sponge, the tip of the sponge, just dip. Oh, it's so pretty. I just want to do this method because I want a really seamless highlight, especially on my wedding day, because I'm that bitch. I want my man to be like, wow, your highlight, babe. That's what I want him to say. You're listening, honey. I'm just kidding. Oh my god, that's so beautiful, you guys. I haven't used these in a while. I forgot how much I love them. I'm just like, pat. And you want it to blend with the blush, with the bronzer, with the contour. You just want it all to work together. A little on the nose. Upper lip and chin. Oh my god, it's so beautiful. Yes, 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 yes. Bitch, yes. Okay, now that's done, I think I'm gonna go in with the loose highlighter. And I want to be even extra popping. I'm just, honey, this is what I'm doing. And we're going to go in with the Kylie Cosmetics. This is the Ultra Loose, like Ultra, I think she calls this the Ultra Glow, her loose highlighters. This is in the shade Fiji. And I want a more like golden kind of color. So I'm going to use this color. If I was really, really pale, I would use Santorini, which is more like vanilla base, where this is more golden, which I love as well. Okay, we're just going to lightly tap that into the cheek. And just, oh my God, that's so beautiful, you guys. Ah! Let me tell you. I know I said I didn't want like a beaming highlight and I knew I was wrong. I'm just telling you. I'm telling you, these loose highlighters, I love them. I want to go similar, like not too dark as my lip color. I want to be really like kind of pinky and natural and not too dark, not too light. Okay. I'm going to go in. This is the Kylie Cosmetics Lip Liner in Candy K. It's such a pretty, like, nude kind of color. It's, like, pink, but not too pink. It's not too nude. It's not too dark. It's, like, the perfect nude, especially for a wedding day. I'm just going to tap this out a little bit. Just because my lips are so dry. All right, I'm just going to apply this all over. All over the lips. I love like a good overline lip. I always overline my lips, but for my wedding day, I wouldn't, just because it kind of like, it's not very flattering, especially when you're kissing people and you're hugging people. It's gonna like, I don't know, it looks ugly because your lip is gonna wear off. I don't know. It's not very like flattering. And you don't want to overline them too much. You want like a little bit of, I did overline them a little bit, but not too much. So you want it pouty, but not too pouty. You know what I mean? Especially for your wedding day. I don't know. This is just like my thing. Okay. Now we're going to go in with the Kylie Cosmetics Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Candy K. Okay. I'm just going to apply this all over the lips. Okay. Okay. And I have to say, Kylie's liquid lips, they do last a really long time. So it's going to last all day. So does Jeffree Star. Okay, we're going to do something different. Because for my wedding day, I want my lips really pouty. So I'm going to go in with Jeffree Star Cosmetics Velour Liquid Lipstick in the shade Mannequin. We just want to add a little bit light color just because you want it like extra pouty. We don't want like a flat lip color. You know what I mean? Okay, we're just gonna apply this and just tap in the middle of the lips. Like this. And this, color from Jeffree Star. It has a really pretty kind of pinky purpley undertone. It's going to complement this lip color and this whole look all together. Gloss. Just because when you're kissing your man, like at the aisle, at the altar, you know what, like, I know my boyfriend doesn't mind lip gloss, but it's kind of gross. It's just gross. Like, I'll kiss him and he's like, oh, I don't mind. I'm like, it's gross though. So usually like if I do see him or if it was my wedding, I would wear like a shiny lipstick because I like a shine to my lips, because also it's super hydrating and moisturizing throughout the day, especially like when you're drinking, you're talking to everyone. I don't want a matte lipstick all day because it's definitely going to dry out on my lips, especially with Kylie and Jeffree Star on my lips, because they do have a really longevity of lasting all day long. But I just want to shine to my lips because my lips are so already dry as they are, but you're not adding a lip gloss, you're just adding a shine lipstick. So I'm going to use the Maybelline New York. Oh, I'm not going to use this one, actually. I'm going to use this one. This is the new one. This is the older one I was using. So this is the Maybelline New York. What is this? Shine. This is the Color Sensational Shine Lipstick. I'll link it below. But this shine lipstick, it's in pink packaging. This is in the shade Baddest Beige. If you guys watch my channel, you know I love this color. It's one of my favorite colors. And it is like lighter than Candy K. So when you apply this, it's going to be really pretty. So we're just going to apply this all over. It's really pretty. Okay. Now, to seal the deal, the final deal, I'm going to use setting spray again. I'm going to go in with the Morphe Continuous Setting Spray. So basically, before we apply brow gel or mascara, I don't want to apply this after I apply my mascara because basically you're going to ruin your makeup. Because like when you apply mascara, you don't want to ruin it with setting spray. Because if you look up, it'll kind of like, you'll have raccoon eyes, especially for my wedding day. I don't want that. So usually I always do this after I put my lipstick. But I only use a lot of the setting spray just because we want our makeup and our skin to look so beautiful. And we don't want our face to look overly powdery. So I'll do this just because I want my makeup to really melt. But we're just going to seal the deal one last time. Your eye makeup look, because if anything has oil in it and you spray your eyes, it's definitely gonna ruin your makeup, especially for your wedding day. You're gonna like, oh, it's gonna be a mess. Can you imagine? My girl. Okay, now we're gonna apply Anastasia brow gel, and for my wedding day, I'm gonna use this bad boy because it's Gorilla Glue and it's gonna make my eyebrows last all day long. Just saying. Whoa, whoa. Okay, I'm just gonna apply this. Okay, and then I'm just gonna go in with the MAC Extended Play Giga Black Lash. I love this mascara, especially for the lower lashes. You wanna get all up in there. Okay, that's looking real good. I'm just gonna curl my hair, put some earrings on. I'll be right back, you guys. Hold on. There you go, you guys. That's it for this tutorial for my wedding makeup look, modern bridal look. I was talking to my mom on the phone, so it's like 10 o'clock, 10:30. It's super late, but I feel really tired earlier because I cleaned all day, but I wanted to film this video for you guys because yesterday I took a break, and yeah. I just wanted to film this really pretty look. I added my diamond earrings and I added these clips. I actually got these from Irie Me collection. They're so cute and so pretty. I actually really like the highlight. It's really, really pretty. I love that Dior little quad. Where are you? I'll just show you guys really quickly. This little guy, this is, I forgot how beautiful these highlights are. I love Dior highlights. They're really, really beautiful and they're beaming. I might use these two down here tomorrow. Who knows? We'll see. I love them. I just think it's so beautiful. I would definitely do this whole entire look on my wedding day. What's that sound? Weird. My neighbors are so loud all the time. They keep knocking all day and it's like so annoying. It's like 10:30. It's like, can't you be quiet? Anyways, you guys, I loved this whole entire highlight. It's so beautiful. Like I loved how gold and peachy it is. And I love this lip color. I love that trick I showed you guys, just adding like a lighter, matte liquid lip just in the center, just gives you a little pout. And if you guys want an added shine to your entire look, you can just like add like a shine lipstick. If you don't want to kiss your man at the altar, with a bunch of lip gloss on your lips, because it's kind of that kind of grosses me out. But yeah, I actually really love this look. It's so weird wearing like a nude lip today, because the last few days I've been doing a really, really bold lip color, which I've been loving. I love doing bold lip colors, but I just wanted to do, you know, kind of take a break from that for a while, because I've been doing a lot of that on my channel lately. And yeah, I just wanted, you know, do like my basic kind of neutral smoky eye, my lip. I would wear this on a regular basis because this is like, this is glam. Like, I love it. I love that I did the side part. Very glam. I would totally wear this for my wedding. Or I kind of like want a half up. That would be so beautiful, but I'm not getting married, but I love my man very much. Him and I have been together almost 3 years, so maybe in the future, but not right now, but we're very content with our relationship and how happy we are. And yeah, I've known him for a while now, so I've known him almost 7 years, but we're not getting married anytime soon. I always thought if I got married, I would want to live with my boyfriend first, because my parents, when they got they're not together anymore, but when my parents got together, they weren't married. They were married, but they didn't live together, and they fought all the time, which is why it didn't work out. But they created me, and look how cute I am. I'm just kidding. And they both love me very much, so I'm glad they got together. But lesson learned. I always thought, like, if I got married, I wanted to last forever. I've never wanted to get married more than once, and I always, like, wanted to live with a boyfriend before I get married. I think you learn so much about each other. I've lived with boyfriends before, but you learn so much about each other. Like when you go on a trip, if you like live together, you just like, it's different when you live with someone. You learn all the little habits and all this little stuff that annoys you. But yeah, but I don't think we're that far in our relationship yet. So I feel like when you live with a boyfriend, yeah, you get to see them more, but when you're fighting, it's like you don't really have anywhere to go, right? But whatever, that's just my own little thing. But I hope you guys really enjoy this wedding look. I would love to do more wedding looks here on my channel. If you guys really like this look, let me know. I would love to do like a series or something. Like I could do like a smoky bridal look. That'll be a lot of fun. I love doing bridal looks. Like they're so much fun. A lot of them are like very similar looks, but I want to just add that black shadow on the lash line because it's so beautiful. And I just love this lip color. This is like an everyday nude. Like it's not too nude. It's like a little bit pinky, and I love the blush. Like I love everything about this look. Yeah. Yeah, I hope you guys really enjoy this wedding tutorial. So I know we're in a pandemic right now. So after the pandemic, if you guys are getting married, definitely do this look, because this look, I would wear it on an everyday basis. It's just so beautiful. And I know this was a little bit of a longer video just because I wanted to include a lot of tips and tricks for you guys, like applying the the setting mist from Morphe before actually applying the eyeshadow. It just made my skin look so flawless. And also I applied the contour, the bronzer, and did the bakeage after I applied the eyeshadow. I feel like my makeup looks better. I might be doing that more often, because I find when I bake and then I apply the eyeshadow and my bakeage is on like for a long time, maybe half an hour, 45 minutes, it's on there a little too long. And then throughout the day, I notice I have a lot of dry skin here. So I might do that routine more often, applying the contour, bronzer, and bakeage after I do my eyeshadow. So I learned something new. I usually just do this on brides. I don't really do it on myself, but it was cool doing it on myself, like what I do on clients, which was pretty awesome. But yeah, I don't know. I'm into it. My skin just looks so flawless and beautiful. And yeah, and I hope you guys can like use this video and routine to do your tips and tricks throughout your regular routine. And I hope you guys liked it. I was really excited to film this video for you guys. I had so much fun filming it. I just think it's so glam and so beautiful. I love it. I loved everything about this look. And I love you guys so much. And thank you for watching. I had so much fun filming. Any other ideas you guys want me to film? I would love if you guys do this video and tag me, I would love that too. Like, I love when you guys do stuff like that. And, you know, if you guys give me ideas and you inspire me, I inspire you back. This is a YouTube community. So I love that about here on YouTube. Anyways, you guys, I'm battling. For tomorrow's look, I was thinking of, since I've been doing really bold lip colors lately, I wanted to do a really bold eye. I was thinking of doing like a really pink smoky eye, which I haven't done on my channel yet. Like, I've done like a little bit of a pink eye, but I haven't done like a really, really pink eye. And I think I want to do like an all matte pink eye. But when I do pink smoky eyes, a lot of women don't like it, but I'm sure you guys will love it because you guys usually love all my looks I do here on YouTube. I find like older ladies, they don't like it. They think I get punched, but I don't. I'm the type of girl, like, I don't care what people think. I do what I want anyways. That's how my personality is. I don't listen to anyone. And if somebody pisses me off, like, I won't talk to them. That's how I am. Like, I'm that bitch. Like, I'll cut you. And I'm a fire sign. I'm like, get the claws out, bitch. That's how I am. But I want to do it for you guys because I know a lot of people, like, a lot of people want to know how to do like light colors and what to blend them out with, so I'm really excited with that. And with the pink eye, I always like to play around with pink highlighters. So I'm gonna look through a few of my makeup collection and see like what pink highlighter will look really pretty. Because for a pink eye look, I don't like to do too much of a bold look. I need that highlight. So I have a few options, so I'm just gonna look at my highlights right now before I do that.
Stack on the Bible, never Snapchat or took Molly. She fall through plenty, her and all her guineas. Yeah, we at the top floor, right there off Dewey. Yeah, oh no, I can't fuck with y'all. Yeah, when I'm with my squad, I cannot do no wrong. Yeah, saucing in the city, don't get misinformed. Yeah, they gon' pull up on you. Yeah, we gon' do some things you can't relate. Yeah, cause we from a place you cannot stay. Or you can't go, or I don't know. Or back the fuck up off me. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time.
I wanna press my line, yeah. I wanna press my. I wanna green like, I wanna be like, I wanna press my line, yeah. I wanna take that ride, yeah. I'm gonna press my line. I wanna green like, I wanna be like, I wanna press my. Mama dear, spare your feelings, I'm reliving moments, feeling more residual. I can buy the building, burn the building, take your bitch, rebuild the building just to fuck some more.
I can justify my love for ya and touch the sky, forgot to stop the beating wall.
Put the pussy on the pedestal, put the pussy on the high hoops, that pussy to die for, that pussy to die for.
Heat a piper, pick the peppers, I can pick your brain and put your heart together. We depart the shady parts and party hard. The diamond sure's the cool forever. My best shot just might shoot forever like.
I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. You come around, yeah. You ease my mind, you make everything feel fine. Worry about those comments, I'm way too numb, yeah. It's way too dumb, yeah.
I get those goosebumps every time. I need the Heimlich, throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time, yeah. When you're not around, when you throw that to the side, yeah. I get those goosebumps every time.